Hi everyone, welcome you all. This is Pawan from SDET channel. So I'm going to start a new series on JavaScript, which is very popular scripting language nowadays in most trending technologies, especially on web-based applications. So in this video, I will discuss a few basic concepts which are needed before learning JavaScript programming. So let's see the agenda. So first we will see the introduction to web-based applications or web applications. And then we will discuss what is client and web servers. And then we will understand what is HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And then we will see what is JavaScript and history of the JavaScript. And finally, we will compare Java with JavaScript languages. So let's start. So first thing is introduction about web applications. So what is basically web application is? A web application or web app is a client-server computing program that the client runs in a web browser. So for example, so let us have a client and the server. So for example, let's say I have a server machine and which is remotely located, and here my web app is installed or my web application is installed, and I can browse this application or I can access this application through the client machine. This is my client machine, and to access this application through the network, I need to have a browser placed in my client machine. So this particular browser can send the request or can send the URL and get the information from the server. So this is basically web application. So web applications will be installed on the web servers, and to access the web applications, we have browser. We need to have the browser, and that browser will present the data which is coming from the web application from the server. And the web application is basically a client server computer program, and that will runs on the web browser. And the common web applications include like webmail, online retail sales, online banking, and search engines. And all these are examples of web applications. Now, what is client and web server? So normally when you work with the web-based applications, the web server is a server or a machine where the applications are installed. And those web applications we can access using multiple clients. And every client is having a browser. And through that browser, we can access those web applications through internet. So in the server side, actual web-based applications or web applications will be installed. And these web applications to develop this business, to develop these web applications or business logic, so we have to use certain programming languages, and this is called as a server side programming. So whatever the programming we have to write in the server side, we can call it as a server side programming. So normally we use Java, Python, C sharp, or any other programming languages to implement the business logic at the server side. And the client side, so these are the different machines, and every client is having a browser, and through the browser I can access the web applications. Our browsers will interpret the data, and the same data will be present to the user. And to interpreting the data from the client and representing the data to the user, we have to write certain language, certain programming here. That is called client-side programming. So normally we use HTML, CSS, JavaScript. So these are all different languages which we can use to write a client-side programming. So basically, the web server is a server or a machine where web apps will be installed, and the clients are the machines from where we can access the web applications through browser. And the programming which we can do at the server side, we can call it as a server side programming. And the programming which we can implement at the client side, we can call it as a client side programming. Now, so what is HTML, CSS, and JavaScript? So especially these languages we use at the client side programming. So again, in the client-server programming, we have HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So every language is having their own purpose. So first of all, let us see what is the usage of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So normally what happens is, let us say I have a server. Let's say this is my server. And I have a client. This is my client machine. So I'm accessing the server. I'm accessing web application from the server using a client. So here I have a browser. Let's say I have a browser here, and through browser I'm accessing my web application. So here what exactly happened is, in the server side, the business logic will be implemented by using programming languages. So once you request the data from the server, from the web application, what exactly will happen here is our browser will act as an interpreter internally. So our browser is having the internal mechanism to interpret the data. So once you get the data from the server, and that particular data should be present to the user in understandable format, right? So here the web page, whatever you are able to see, that those web pages will be developed by using hypertext markup language. We can say HTML. So HTML is nothing but hypertext markup language. And by using this HTML language, we can design the skeleton of the web page. So all the elements, whatever you can see on the web page, like text boxes, input boxes, radio buttons, list boxes, all these elements we can design by using HTML. And this will basically provide the skeleton of the web page. Now, on top of this HTML, there will be CSS, cascading style sheets. And basically this CSS will apply the design on the skeleton. And then your web pages looks very attractive. And we can apply the colors, we can apply some designs, alignment, all these things we can take care of by using CSS. So CSS we can apply on top of HTML. So HTML is providing the skeleton of the web page, and CSS will apply the design on that particular skeleton, and it will basically take care of look and feel of your web page. And apart from this, to make our pages dynamic, or if you want to apply a dynamic behavior to the web page, then we have to add JavaScript. We have to add JavaScript. So HTML will take care about the skeleton or structure of the web page, and CSS will take care about the design of your web page and look and feel of your web page. And JavaScript will use it for applying the dynamic nature of your website. Suppose if you want to get the dynamic data from the server, like if you want to apply some animations, right? So all these things will be done by using JavaScript. So if you understand very clearly, we can say simply HTTP, hypertext markup language HTML, is a skeleton of the web. It is used for displaying the web. That means the page structure. And CSS is like our clothes. We put on our fashionable clothes to even look better, right? So it is basically talking about the design. So similarly, the web is quite stylish as well. So it uses CSS, which stands for cascading style sheet, for styling the purpose. So we can apply the styles on the web page. And then JavaScript. So JavaScript, which puts life into the web page. That means it will make the, or it will apply the dynamic behavior to the website or web page. So it will add dynamic nature to the web. But where exactly we have to place this? Suppose the JavaScript, HTML is a language. We will have HTML file, and CSS is also have another file, and JavaScript is also have another file. So normally, in the client, we use browser to access the web application. So browser is basically used for representing the data or present the data to the user. Suppose let us say this is my browser. So this is my browser. So user, the browser will present the data to the user. But internally, what exactly happen is, in this browser, the elements will be designed by HTML. So this is my HTML. So where exactly JavaScript will be reside? JavaScript will be hosted by HTML. So within the HTML script itself, we have to include the JavaScript. Okay, so HTML is a language which will host the JavaScript. And HTML is provide the structure of the web page, and basically it is a skeleton. And inside this, we will add the dynamic behavior. And if I use a plain HTML, that is a static web page. And if I include JavaScript inside the HTML, then your web page will become dynamic. And CSS is applying for stylish nature, or if you want to apply any colors or design, we can use CSS on top of HTML. So this is a relation between HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So JavaScript is basically client-side scripting language. Even HTML also, hypertext markup language. So basically browsers can understand only markup languages, like HTML, DHTML, XML. So these are the markup languages. So browser can always understand this markup language, and it will interpret these languages. Right? So JavaScript is a client-side scripting language. Now, let us move on to the next one. What is JavaScript? So just now we have seen the relationship between HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Now let us discuss in detail about what is JavaScript. So JavaScript is high level interpreted programming language used to make web pages more interactive. So normally if I use plain HTML, we can design static web page, right? But if you want to make it dynamic, for example, if you want to apply some movements or actions, or if you want to get some data from the server, dynamic data, right? I want to make the web pages dynamic or more interactive. So to do this, we have to use JavaScript as a client-side scripting language. So it is interpreted and executed on the client machine. So as I said, the client is having the browser. So let us say this is my client. The client is having the browser. So it can be Chrome, Internet Explorer, Firefox, whatever it is, the client is having the browser. So whatever HTML is there, this HTML will be interpreted by the browser. So where the JavaScript will be resided, the JavaScript will be resided inside the HTML. Here the JavaScript will be there. So JavaScript code will be hosted by the HTML, and JavaScript and HTML both will be interpreted by the browser. And that browser will be reside inside the client machine. Now, it is also used as a default scripting language within HTML. So as I said earlier, the JavaScript is hosted by the HTML. Now, the JavaScript will reduce the load on the server as some operations. So for example, guys, for every request, we no need to go to the server, right? So let us say I have a server and here I have a client. So normally the client will send the request to the server and server will give the response to the client, right? So if there are any complex operations, we have to definitely go to the server and get the data. And there are certain operations which we have to do only from the server side, only from the server side. And here server side programming will take care of it. But there are certain operations or smaller operations, we can perform them within the client side itself. We don't need to go to the server every time. In that case, JavaScript can be used to perform certain operations at the client side. So if I perform certain operations at the client side itself, we don't need to go to the server every time. And that will reduce the load on the server, right? So let us say I have 100 operations I need to perform. So for every request, if I go to the server, the load will be increased. And almost 50% operations, if I done in the client side, the load on the server will be reduced. So that's the meaning, reduces the load on the server as some operations, because the scripting languages or client server, client side programming also provide certain kind of operators, data types, loops, everything will be there. So we can also do certain operation from the client side. The next one is, it is very powerful client side scripting language, which makes your web page more lively and interactive. So as I said earlier, HTML will decide only the static pages. The same content every time will be there. And JavaScript will add the dynamic nature to the web pages. And your web pages seems very lively and more interactive to the user. And JavaScript is case sensitive language. Like Java, JavaScript is also a case sensitive language. And it will add some dynamic nature to the web pages. So by using JavaScript, we can add some dynamic nature to the web pages. So that is about the JavaScript. Now, what is the history of JavaScript? So JavaScript basically started in 1995. The first version of Java is 1.0. And this language initially supported Netscape Navigator 2.0. version. So Netscape Navigator is a browser which was there around 1995. At that time, there is only one browser, that is Netscape Navigator. And JavaScript initially implemented for Netscape Navigator 2.0. And in the 1996, JavaScript 1.0, we can call it as also JScript 1.0. And it is also started supporting Microsoft Internet Explorer 3.0. After that, 1997, JavaScript 1.2 is released, and this is also supported Netscape Navigator along with Internet Explorer, and we can call it as a JScript 3.0 version. And in 1998, so JavaScript 1.3 is released, which will support Netscape Navigator 4.5 along with Internet Explorer. And in 1999, it becomes full-fledged JavaScript in 1.3, and we can call it as a JScript 5.0. And it is started supporting Microsoft Internet Explorer 5.0. So from there onwards, JavaScript becomes very popular in the market. So this is the initial development history. Now, so this is a basic JavaScript history. And nowadays, most of the browsers are supported by JavaScript. So you can compile or import JavaScript by Chrome, Internet Explorer, Firefox. Almost every browser is supported by JavaScript in the current market. Now, let's move on to the next slide. So Java versus JavaScript. So JavaScript, the word itself contains Java. But is there any relation between Java or JavaScript? So what are the differences? When we have to use Java, when we have to use JavaScript? Now let us see that. So Java is basically object-oriented programming language. It's purely object-oriented programming language. But whereas JavaScript is object-oriented programming scripting language. So programming language is a little different than scripting language. So programming language normally used for developing a business logic at the server side. But scripting language can be used to design the web pages, to add the dynamic behavior to the web pages, like HTML, DHTML, XML, JavaScript, JSP. These are all scripting languages. And both are object-oriented features supported. Now, Java runs on virtual machine on browser. So sometimes we can also run Java on browser. So in Java is also having internal JSP components. By using them, we can also run our some programs on the browser, but we need a virtual machine. And JavaScript runs on a browser only. So JavaScript especially designed for client-side programming. So it runs only on the browser. It needs a browser interpreter. Now in Java, code is compiled before execution. So before executing your program, your code will be compiled and it will generate the class file. When you come to the JavaScript, code is interpreted. And the internet is having JIT compiler. And the JIT compiler basically compile the code before execution. On top of the compilation, it will interpret the JavaScript statement. So internally, just-in-time compiler will take care of the compiling the code inside the interpretation. So then code will be interpreted by the browser. And Java is a static type checking. It supports static type checking. And in JavaScript, dynamic type checking is there. So static type checking in the sense, all the data types, right? So everything we have to specify. So that's the statistically we have to specify. And in the dynamic type checking means, suppose if I don't specify any data type or anything else, by default, JavaScript will be added some data types depends upon the value. So dynamic type checking will be there. So at the time of compilation in Java, a static type checking is supported. In the JavaScript, dynamic type checking is supported. So these are the basic differences we have in Java and JavaScript. So Java is server-side programming language, and we can also do somehow client-side programming by using JSP components. But in JavaScript, is purely client-side programming language, and especially it is a scripting language. All right, and both are completely different. Right, so that is all about Java versus JavaScript. So that's all for this video, guys. So we'll continue the next video. So thanks for watching.